Já očeň radost, to já magu zde zbyť. No, k sožalení, já nebudu gavariť po rusky, potom už to vy by smějali, si ulevali s celou moju prezentáciu, já by nemagla gavariť. Tak izviníte mi, já luče budu gavariť po anglicky. No, já vám chtěla rozkazať, što to o našom opitě, o opitě mojej organizácii. Prieždy všeho, já bych skazala, što já byla 12 let členom pravitelstva Prágy, a member of a city council. U mě už je prezentácia. Spasivo. Tak já začnu gavariť po anglicky. No. So my presentation will be quite short because there should be already a break. So first of all, I will say a few words about my organization so that you know who I am. Then I will speak about the differences. I think it fits very well to today's presentations. This will be more about theory, how to involve people, and then there will be a practical example from Prague, which we did a few years ago. So my organization was founded 15 years ago with the help of Dutch organizations, because they were helping us with accessing European Union. And our main goal is to make citizens more active and to make politicians listening to citizens. It's a hard role. We are working on many projects, teams of them, we call it participatory projects. And the teams of the projects are involvement of citizens in decision making, in strategy planning, urban planning, transport strategies, very different issues. And we work in many countries, mainly in Eastern Partnership countries or Balkan countries. And we also organize debating projects for students because we find out that Czech people during the times of communism were forced to be silent. So we as Czechs are not very good in debating, discussing. And we organize different training seminars, conferences. So when speaking about communication with citizens, we always have to pose these three basic questions. What do we want to achieve? It seems simple, but if you have a town hall and citizens and officers, then very often their perceptions, what they want, is different. So at the beginning, you have to find common ground. The second most important question is who are the stakeholders? Who will be people influenced by the decisions? And of course, what methods do we use? This seems also very simple, but it is not. The premises of good communication are always the willingness on both sides, even if the politicians say, by the way, how many politicians are there in the hall? Please raise your hands who are politicians. Пожалуйста, поднимите руку, кто из вас политик или работает в мэрии. Спасибо. Нет, много я могу говорить. Но я была также политиком, я могу говорить также за политиков. Takže когда, so if the, even if the politicians say they want to communicate, they sometimes think about something different than people. There has to be respect and trust. I don't know how is it in Kyrgyzstan, but in Czech Republic, 20 years after the revolution, the gap between people and politicians is enormous. People don't trust politicians. They think there is only corruption and stealing, and it's very bad. There should be some partnership. You don't have the interpretation?
Yeah.
Aha, okay, so I can say. Oh. So I will say the Russian at the beginning.
Yeah, I can, by the way, show the Russian. Will you be okay to?
Yes, I hope I will. Tak prieždy všeho, ja uznala, že to zdetne, net pierevod, tak ja papitaju s paruskom. Prieždy všeho, my dalžiny ustrojiť štoto, što nazývajú sa partnerstvo s graždanami. A to značí, što ani na jedinakovom úrovne s politikami. A to net vsegda rabota je tchorašo. I my dalžiny znať, kak my dagavarím sa s nimi, metody, know-how. Здесь написаны типичные этапы участия граждан. Я не буду длинное время об этом говорить, но я могу сказать, что всегда в Чехии, например, мэрии только информируют. У нас есть магазины, которые раздают мэрия во все семьи об этом, что они делают, но не получают никакие информации от граждан, только информируют граждан. Второй степень есть консультирование, мы спрашиваем граждан. Но что мы хотим в Агоре, есть партнерство, чтобы граждане были партнерами с политиками и с чиновниками. Потом самый высший степень есть делегирование правомочи или контрол граждан. Мы здесь об этом говорили. Вот этот степень очень тяжелый для политиков и также для граждан. Мы должны очень хорошо информировать граждан, чтобы они знали, о чем обсуждают. Но потом мэрия им может отдать деньги, чтобы они решали и строили что-то маленькое с этими деньгами. И я должна сказать, что всегда, когда граждане получают, это децентрализация, об этом говорили, когда деньги идут vniz, всегда лучше пользуются, чем когда кто-то решает сверху. Вy все знаете, я не буду. Oh, I think it's okay. Ай-яй-яй. Так, извините, проблемы с переводом. Так. Okay. Какие шаги в процессе вовлечения? Мы всегда, мы скажем, что это 7 шагов, но можно это сократить. Первое, мы должны все договориться, что мы хотим. Подготовка – это самое крупное дело, потому что политики думают, что они хотят что-то, как я уже сказала, граждане хотят что-то другое. И мы, как независимый модератор, потому что мы неправительственная организация, и мы независимые модераторы этих процессов. И мы должны точно узнать, что кто хочет, потому что когда мы всегда работаем с мэрией. Когда я была политиком, я узнала, если граждане против чего-то, они только ворують, но мэрия скажет, мы не хотим. И ничего не осуществится. Я люблю процессы, когда люди договорятся, чтобы граждане договорились с мэрией. Мне нравится, когда все работают вместе. Так мы работаем с теми мэриями, которые хотят договориться с гражданами, но потом в первое мы должны очень хорошо подготовить процесс и узнать, что они хотят. Виды мотивации граждан, которыми мы пользуемся, я очень быстро буду шагать по тому, что будет потом конкrétní projekt, na kakom já pokažu. No my například dajom ankety v každou simiu. My pýtajem sa, što vy chatíte, što vám nravica v gorde, što vám nenravica. Ili my sdělem vystávky, razné sabitia, ili sarevnovania. Já dúmaju, što zdes bude tak, že kako je sarevnovanie. Další stěpeň, ktorým polzujem sa, jest občestvená vstereča. Zde kartinky z různých городов v Čechii, občestvené vstereči. Potom atličné semináry. No, já должна сказать, что принятие решений есть в руках граждан, но okay. I'll better go to English. Sorry. Excuse me.
Если вы переключите канал, когда Ивана говорит на английском, там есть перевод на русском. 5 и 6, верно? Просто переключайтесь там колесиком между 5 и 6, хорошо? То есть перевод есть, все исправно работает.
Спасибо большое. I wanted to make it easier for you, but it's more difficult for me. Excuse me. So the very important step of our work is public meetings. When we invite the whole city, by very different means. The means were described as a motivation, and the motivation is crucial. If we make a wrong motivation, we don't get the people to the public meeting. And public meeting is something which is very feared by politicians in our country, because politicians are used to fierce public meetings where people are fighting with them. But our public meetings are very constructive, and we are trying to reach good results. Then people come to some conclusions, but of course the decisions is on politicians. So is their role to decide and to fulfill the goals. The important role of politicians is that they have to inform the society all the time. Otherwise, there never is enough informing. So the last thing I will show is a concrete project. It's from Prague too, and I didn't know that you have problems with inner yards, which was described yesterday at the ecological section. Otherwise, I would choose a different project, but just it's quite similar. So in Prague too, we organized a project where Agora was the independent moderator. I think it's always very good to have some independent moderator, because if town hall is organizing something, people have prejudices. If people are organizing something, town hall is afraid it will be against them. So it's much better if someone from outside is organizing it. At this particular project, there was a big company, Philip Morris, and they wanted to improve the surroundings. We as Agora have to solve at first whether we will work with Philip Morris, because they, in a way, are killing people by smoking. So it was a difficult decision for us, and then we decided, okay, we will do it. So Philip Morris wanted to look as a good neighbor and change some public space. Prague too, the district of Prague, this is a central district, the red one, so it's very visible in the city. They wanted to get some money for renovation of public spaces, and we wanted to try a new project. The first step of the project was terrible. It was, we had to reach some consensus what to do, and the company is thinking very differently. It's also about public-private partnership. The company thinks about money, so they thought, we have the money, we can invest in the public space. But the public space belongs to the city, so they have to reach the conclusion with the city, and they have to involve the Department of Planning and all that stuff. They wanted to skip it, so my role was to explain them this is not possible. It was really a very hard job. Then, they have enough money, so we had enough sources to involve people, which was very good. They put stands in the city, they were visible everywhere, and they even sent personal letters to people. It was very good if you open a personal letter where the mayor is writing to you, come and tell me what you think about the city. It's very well working. It's the best motivation. And then we post enquetes to the households asking which piece of land, which part of the Prague 2, which part of green area would you like to change. Then we created the big public meeting I showed you before. People have chosen one of the districts, and then we organized seminars with architects where people were planning with the architect. Of course, the architect is, where is the architect? People are always not enough informed, but they are the best experts on their city because they live in the city. So the architects are very good to finalize the visions, but they need the background from people. Otherwise, they will make the city without people, as was said before. Here are some pictures from the way how we involved citizens. As I said, it was used quite a lot of money. So they had these green stands. They were distributing green balloons, leaflets with information and with questionnaire. They were even giving people warm tea because it was in winter. So they attracted, or we attracted, a lot of people to take part in the project. Then we distributed this questionnaire asking people which particular place would you like to change. Many questions about different things, also about transport. You can use this questionnaire for many other issues. You get many information from citizens. And these are the results of the questionnaire. So people were choosing different different spaces in Prague too, and as you can see, 14% decided they would like to change a neighborhood around the Church of St. Stefan. There are pictures from the public meeting. This is one of our, I think, masterpieces. To organize a public meeting when you reach with 100, 200 people, some conclusions, you get some concrete results for people, from people, and each of the people can say something. It's not like that you're sitting, and I'm talking, and after an hour you're bored and you go home. This is a place where each of the citizens can write something, say something, and it will be given to the town hall. So all the information from people are gathered. It's a great source for the town hall. They got a lot of information they can use also later. This is the surrounding of the St. Stefan Church in Prague. It is before the reconstruction, and on the bottom picture you can see the group of citizens with the architect. They are discussing how it should look like. They are discussing how are they using the space, because this is the information that the architect doesn't have. The architect looks at the place as an architectural space, but people are walking there. So the architect usually plans the roads like this, but people are walking like this. So that's why the people's input is very important. So this is the final study made by the architect. And this is how it looked for people. Again, you have to transform the visions of architects to something which is tangible for people, so that they understand what will be on the place. They cannot get a map because they won't understand it, but they can understand this picture. On the other side, you cannot cheat them. You cannot make the tree 10 times bigger, because this is the way, how the architects sometimes do it. The house is so small and the tree is so big, but people are not stupid. So it has to be clear for them. And so, this is my last slide. These are lessons learned from the process, or I've been working in including people into decision making for 15 years. So these are the results of my 15 years work in Czech Republic, also in other countries. I think it's everywhere quite similar, though the problems are different. The first thing is you have to start on time. If you prepare, my city unfortunately is now preparing a strategy. The brilliant strategy that will be given to people when it will be ready. It's completely wrong. I cannot change it, though I'm doing my best. At the beginning, the people should be involved, give their opinion before the strategy, before the plan is prepared, or it's too late. Then, second important thing is motivation of people. You have to use all possible means, because there is never enough information. We are all overloaded by television, newspaper, whatever. And the man from Germany spoke about it yesterday. They were doing their best, but people were not informed. They will never be informed enough. So motivation, use all different methods. Play with people, do exhibitions, work with children. Otherwise, you will not get them. Then another trick is the way how to organize public meetings. If anybody's interested, I can speak about it later personally, because I think this is one of our know-hows. You have to choose a place and a setting. It has to be done well, otherwise it might be a disaster. And you prepare concrete solutions in workshops, seminars, but again, the most crucial is informing the people what has been decided. So I think that's all. Okay, and I wish you good luck with involvement of citizens, even if you think that the politicians are corrupted, and even if the politician thinks that the citizens are not interested and lazy. I think it's very much worth trying, and if you need any kind of experience from Czech Republic, I am happy to share it with you. Thank you.